Welcome back to Return of the Phantom, last episode. Well, our friend Cheese Brie is leaving the room, and you are perplexed. Was it a dream? It couldn't have been. It was too real. Wait, what about Madame Giry's book? You decide to check on what the book says about the Phantom's demise. You quickly turn to the last paragraph, which reads, Eric, the Phantom of the Opera, met his death along with the brave Raoul de Chagny in 1881. What? When the chandelier upon which the two men were fighting fell from the ceiling. Monsieur de Chagny was given a hero's burial while the Phantom was buried in an unmarked pauper's grave. But the artifacts were kept in the opera's library for safekeeping. I do believe that the world has heard the last of Eric, the Phantom of the Opera. What? The ending has changed. You quickly thumb through the book once again to make sure. What kind of trick have the forces of destiny played on you? You realize now that you somehow managed to save the life of not only Christine Day, but Christine Florent. And as for the Phantom, he is gone forever. Or is he? There is no such thing as chance, and what to us seems merest accident springs from the deepest source of destiny. Friedrich Schiller, 1759-1805. You have achieved a score of 250 out of 250 possible points. This gives you the rank of a director, and I hardly ever get the full score in my adventure games, so I'm very happy about this. But I must say, while the credits are running, there are very many open questions. As I already mentioned, what did Raoul have to do on the catwalk to begin with if there was no chandelier accident back in 1993? And I didn't really like this alternate ending because Raoul died as well and had no chance to run off with Christine Day, thus make no kids with her, and thus, who in the world is Christine Florent? Questions over questions, which can give us nightmares, and something to think about it. Was it all real, or was it a dream? Or was it maybe just an adventure game? Well, I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play. I was enjoying playing through it, and I liked it a lot. I really had forgotten all about it, that I have the CD and all that, so I thought it was a nice thing to play it for you. And as I already mentioned in the first part, I might play it in German along with Anna, and maybe some others, and we would simultaneously translate it for our German viewers, as we did so many Sierra games before in the past few months. And well, what else can I say? Well, I'm still a little bit surprised about this ending and don't really know what to think about it. But all in all, it was a pretty good game. I liked the graphics. The music was very atmospheric, though it was only MIDI, but that doesn't mean that it was still nice. And yeah, I think that's about it, so enjoy the credits. And I'll come back to you at the end. Yeah, a very good quality assurance team. I must say, this game was bug-free. There were no dead ends to it. Unless you didn't collect any item you needed to get back into the past, you had just to look for them, and you could never end up somewhere and be stuck. I think at least I didn't, so that was nice. No bugs, only one death. Well, two if you count the one at the end. And it was a very, very well made game. The Phantom Team would like to thank the following individuals for their additional contributions. Robert Pomery, Steve Goldstein, Doug Kaufman, Kate Morrill, Randy Frank, and Sid Meyer. This is a work of fiction. Any similarities between persons living or dead and characters in the story are entirely coincidental, except for Edgar Degas, who was a real painter, and who may or may not have been a lecherous old man. But you know, he did paint all those pictures of young ballerina. Oh, never mind. So, I guess that's the end of the game. The credits are through, and we get back to the start screen. And I say, once again, thanks to you all for watching, and stay tuned in for my next LPs. Bye-bye!